Hey folks, I'm Andy and this is Now Guitar, the channel where I teach you to play songs acoustically so that you can play them without a band. I keep them super simple and stay away from all the fluff so that you can get playing the song as soon as possible. To help you with learning the song as soon as possible, I have for you as always the one-page song guide. It is there. I've created it for you to make your life easier. Go and grab it via the description down below or in the first comment. Completely free, so no reason not to grab it. Very quickly, a shout out to my mate Marcus Winwood, who gave me the idea of teaching this song. At the moment, Aussie songs is a bit of an experiment, so let me know down underneath if you want me to do more Aussie songs. If I don't hear from you guys and the reception isn't there for it, then I'll go back to just doing big songs. This song contains something that is one of my favorite things on acoustic, which is loads and loads of open strings. You can kind of treat this as bar chords without the bar is the easiest way to think about it. So if you look at some of these names and you're a beginner intermediate and you have trouble with bar chords, you'd probably be thinking, oh, F sharp minor, G sharp minor, this sounds like a bunch of bar chords. Normally it would be, but with this approach, it's not. So we're starting off, we've got an E chord, standard old E chord. From there, we've got what would be an F sharp minor, but it doesn't have the bar. So here's what we're doing. We're gonna get the four and the four, and we're gonna get the second fret on the G string, but everything else, the beauty of open strings is open. Now we are going to go lighter on that E string or avoid it sometimes while we're doing these other chords, but you definitely can catch it. The next chord is the G sharp minor. It's the same treatment. What would be a big bar chord there is going to be same shape on the fourth and sixth fret. Other than that, we've also got an A major bar chord, but unbarred. Reminds me of Unplugged all those years ago. Eric Clapton and everyone else doing their Unplugged albums. Unbarred is what this is. So if we take our bar chord there, we're going to take away the bar, and it's an E shape, basically, on the 6th and 7th frets. And then we're going to do the same treatment up 2 frets again to make a B bar chord without the bar. So essentially we've got an E chord, a minor chord on the 2, minor chord on the 4, a major chord on the 5, and major chord on the 7. So 3 shapes that we've got there. Just doing that to begin with is a nice way to get comfortable with it. Little bit of work up front, which will then mean that you're going to be heaps more comfortable getting through the whole thing. Here's your super hack. Your super pro tip. First finger links all of these together. Check out my first finger. Hear my first finger, squeak. Running back down. If you put that little bit of effort in to begin with, the song's gonna be a piece of cake for you. So, what are we doing for our strumming pattern? Down, down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, up. Try it on the E chord, nice and slow. 3, 4. Down, down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, up. E, F sharp, G sharp, back down to the F sharp. Or if we think about where our first finger is, first fret. Minor shape on the second fret. Minor shape on the fourth fret. So that is our A, G sharp, A, B. And if you're thinking of your first finger, remember that we can slide that around. Your first finger is going to be on the sixth, down to the fourth for the minor chord, back up to the sixth for the A major, slide it up to the eighth for the B. Back to our original progression again. From there, it's the chorus. And guess what? We do exactly the same thing. We just do it bigger. One, two, three, da 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 da. F sharp minor, G sharp minor, back to F sharp. How to Make Gravy. Of course, big shout out to the Luca Brasi boys, Hometown. They do an amazing cover of it. You can check it out on YouTube. They did a live version in at Triple J, and it's a burla. And also check out my buddy Marcus Winwood's version, and go and check out Paul Kelly's version as well while you're at it. Little tale for you on the side here. My first encounter of Paul Kelly live was years ago in Newcastle. Visited a mate who was working at a theatre, and the night that I arrived, he was working at the theatre and Paul Kelly was playing. So he said, "Oh, I'll sneak you into the theatre so you can watch Paul Kelly." So it was an illegal viewing of Paul Kelly. It was the first time I ever got to see him play this song, and it was amazing. So good memories there. If you enjoy the fact that I make the free song guide available for you, I do it for you. Be sure to, first of all, make use of it. Go and grab it and hit that like button. Leave me a comment down underneath if you want to hear more song lessons that are Aussie song lessons. And of course, do yourself a favour by subscribing and hitting the ding-a-ling bell so you get notified when I put up new lessons here on the channel. Thanks for your support. My name's Andy, this is Now Guitar. See you for more soon. Save countless hours searching for easy songs to learn and download my Easy Songs Cheat Sheet. Click the link in the description now to get it absolutely free.